हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट फर्स्ट एड। नाउ व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एंड व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रोवाइडिंग फर्स्ट एड, प्री हॉस्पिटल ट्रीटमेंट, फर्स्ट केयर व्हिच इज गिवन टू द विक्टिम, व्हिच इज गिवन टू द इंजर्ड पर्सन, नाउ दिस फर्स्ट एड इट इज लिमिटेड टू द असिस्टेंस रेंडर्ड एट द टाइम ऑफ इमरजेंसी विद सच मटेरियल्स एज मे बी अवेलेबल। द materials which is available nearby you, so with that limited assistance you have to work. And when you are giving pre-hospital treatment, pre-hospital care, it is not intended that the first aider he should take the place of a doctor, and he must understood that the redressing of these injuries and other such after treatment are outside the scope of a first aid. So being MFR, it is our duty to provide first care, to collect the data, to alert additional emergency medical services. We are not doctors, we are not taking place of doctor, but our work is just to provide first aid, just to provide first care. There are golden rules when you are treating the victim, we are treating the patient. First thing, while following the golden rules, while giving the pre-hospital care, first care, do first thing very quickly, first quickly, calmly, quietly, and don't get panic when you are providing the first treatment. Whenever you are providing the first care, give artificial respiration. When you will assess and you confirm that breathing has stopped, yes, you have to give artificial respiration too. Firstly, when there are injuries, your first work while following the golden rules is to stop whatever bleeding happens. You have to guard against or treat for the shock by moving the casualty as little as possible and handling him gently. While following the golden rules, you have to reassure the casualties. Do not allow people to crowd. Yes, when certain accident happens, certain injuries happens, at that time you will observe the crowd. Please, when you are giving first care, please do not allow crowd around that victim, as a fresh air is needed, as fresh air is essential. We know that when we are giving first aid, at that time we have to remove the clothes, but assure that whether it is necessary, please do not remove the clothes unnecessarily. Arrange for the removal of the casualty to the care of a doctor or hospitals as soon as possible. Please move. Please arrange the removal of this casualty to the care center, to the care of doctor or nearest PHC, primary health care, or any health centers as quick as possible. When you are giving care, when you are providing the first aid, you should have followed certain facts. You must have PPE. You must go on with this PPE, that is personal protective equipment, which we have already discussed while talking about emergency medical services and when we were talking about MFR. Yes, latex gloves, very much important, because you are going to handle the victim and you don't know what sort of injuries he is having, what sort of infection he is having, you don't know. In this case, as we know that you have to work as an MFR, first of all you should take your care, then that care of that victim that you have to take. Personal mask you must have. You must have eye protection, goggle, you should have a CPR mask if suppose there is need to provide a CPR, that is cardiopulmonary resuscitation. You should have this mask as if suppose you have to provide breathing, external breathing. You should have a gown so that protection from the body fluid. Then when you are going to assess that patient, initially what sort of assessment you will be carrying, what sort of assessment you will be undergoing. First of all, see the general impression of that victim, of that patient. Confirm whether that victim, whether that patient, his or she is responsive or not. That means you have to check the responsiveness. Assure that whether airway is open or airway is closed. Then check for the breathing. Whether breathing is present, whether breathing is absent. Check breathing by LLF, look, listen and feel method. While discussing assessment, I will discuss this in the next lecture. Check circulation, whether circulation is present, whether circulation is absent. Patient status, up to date, that you have to mark. And then go for the physical examination. First of all, initially assess that victim, then go for the physical examination. When you are carrying physical examination, you have to follow DOTS. DOTS stands for deformity. See, observe whether there is any sort of deformity is there in that victim, in that patient. Any type of open injury, if it is there. See the tenderness and see the swelling. This you have to observe when you are going for physical examination. When you will be examining physically, start with the head region, then check at the neck region, then check chest and back region, then come towards abdominal region, then the pelvis region, and lastly check upper extremities, that is arms, and then the lower extremities, that is legs. That you have to check. When you are assessing the victim, when you are assessing the patient, when you are providing a first care at that time, you should know the vital signs. Commonly vital signs are called as RP, SP and BP, where R stands for respiration. Check whether proper respiration is there. Rate of respiration is proper. Check for the pulse. Check for the circulation. Then check for the skin, whether skin is changing color, whether it is showing pale yellow color, bluish in color, because itself skin color represents different symptoms. Then check the pupils. We know we have mobile, we have torch. We can check the pupils, whether it is responsive or not. Then check the blood pressure, whether blood pressure it is high, whether blood pressure it is low, that you have to check. Then you have to know the history of that patient. For that purpose, sample you have to follow. What sample is, where S stands for sign and symptoms. What sort of sign, what sort of symptoms are shown by that victim or that patient. This yes tells. Then take the information about the allergies. If you are going to assess the patient at that time by their relatives, by the bystanders, by the friends or whatever with that victim is there, you have to check for the sample. You have to go for the sample. S stand for sign and symptoms. A for allergies, whether that victim is having certain allergies or what. Then whether he was undergoing certain medications, whether he was undergoing certain treatments, that you have to check. You should know about past history of that victim, past history of that patient. Whether he has taken certain oral intake, that you have to confirm when you are going to assess. and from which events he passed. This you have to give. That means you should know the patient history. And you should prepare a data sheet, which is called as patient handoff, where these points should be added. The point should be patient's age and sex. What is chief complaint that you should write on one sheet? What sort of responsiveness he is showing? What sort of airway status, whether it was closed, whether it was open, or you have opened, that you have to mention. What is breathing status? Now the status of breathing and before the status of breathing, that you have to give in that handoff report. Physical exam findings, what you find, whether when you undergone physical assessment at that time, if you have seen certain injuries, certain deformities, open injuries, tenderness or swelling, suppose is there, that you have to write down in the handoff. Then sample history, yes, just we have discussed, that you have to mention in that handoff report. And what sort of medication or the treatment if you have provided, that you have to mention. Age and sex, this plays very important role. So let me define the age. Infant, we used to call under 1 year of age as an infant. Up to the 8 years, from 1 year, we used to call child. And 9 years and above, we consider under adults. In infant, child and adult, it shows different respiratory rates. In infants, it is 25 to 50 RPM. In child, 15 to 30 RPM. And in adults, it is 12 to 20 RPM respiratory rate is present. In case of pulse rate, it is high in infant, followed by child, followed by adult, where you will find 120 to 150 pulse per minute in infant, 80 to 150 pulse per minute in child, and in the adult, you will find 60 to 80 pulse per minute. So this is definition of pulses in adult, child and infant. And you should know about skin temperature. You have to check the temperature. The normal temperature it is, if you count in Fahrenheit, then it is 98.6 and 37 degrees Celsius as far as normal individual is concerned. So these are certain golden rules. These are certain precautions that you have to take when you are providing care, when you are giving first aid, when you are providing pre-hospital care to the victim. So, thank you very much for calm listening. Thank you so much.